ex-wife took the whole damn planet in the divorce. All I got left is my bones.
This is Karl Urban. You probably know him as Dr. Leonard Bones McCoy in the Star Trek reboots. You might remember him as Éomer from the Lord of the Rings series, and he currently stars as Billy Butcher, a vigilante taking down corrupt superheroes in the Amazon original series, The Boys.
We need each other.
Karl was born in New Zealand, so once he left Victoria University of Wellington after a year to pursue acting, he made the rounds on various TV shows in his home country, his first role being an opiate addict on the crime drama Shark in the Park. But he could come off as a clean-cut guy, like in this pilot for the show Homeward Bound, helping his dad set up a family reunion.
And how can you not trust him as this polite young man in an episode of White Fang?
Nice meeting you, Matt. I'll catch you later.
What a nice boy.
Well, looks can be deceiving.
Couldn't keep away from it, could you? David.
Then, starting in 1996, he got some international exposure, playing several different characters in episodes of Xena Warrior Princess, sometimes crossing over into Hercules The Legendary Journeys, since the two shows share the same universe. His biggest character was the megalomaniacal Julius Caesar, a main antagonist of the show over several seasons. But he also provided some comic relief, adding to the campiness of the show, especially when he played Cupid, the god of love.
You go to sleep right now, and I'll get you a dog.
It wasn't until 2002 when Karl's career began to really get some momentum with more international projects. He played Munder, a member of the salvage crew in the cult horror film Ghost Ship, and a supporting character, the noble Éomer, in The Two Towers and Return of the King.
Saruman has poisoned the mind of the king and claimed lordship over his lands.
But he was also good at playing bad guys, like a Russian hitman in The Bourne Supremacy and Commander Vako in The Chronicles of Riddick. And he ended up being the hero in the film adaptation of the video game, Doom. There's even a whole scene from his first-person perspective, just like the game. Does that mean that Karl is technically this Doom guy from the game? He kinda looks like him, actually. But this level of horror doesn't even hold a candle to an indie thriller that came out the following year called Out of the Blue, a raw depiction of a real shooting that occurred in New Zealand, with Karl playing just a regular cop who has to dig deep and find the courage to take on an awful situation. Then, of course, Karl's real big break came as Leonard Bones McCoy, a role he reportedly nailed perfectly in the audition. It can be tough to play a character that another actor has already put such a stamp on, like DeForest Kelly with Bones. But Karl managed to find a middle ground of making the character his own while at the same time paying tribute to the original performance.
Congratulations, Jim. Now we've got no captain and no damn first officer to replace him.
In addition to continuing to play Bones in the Star Trek sequels, he was in the short-lived series Almost Human as a cop in a dystopian future who begrudgingly works with an android partner. He played Scourge, who sacrifices himself in battle in Thor Ragnarok, and although it didn't perform too well at the box office, Dread, starring Karl as the title character, has received kind of a cult following over the years, with rumors of a possible sequel eventually.
Judgment time.
Karl Urban is worthy of perhaps one of the highest compliments an actor can receive.
He can pretty much play anything.
Good guys becoming bad guys becoming good guys, and in the case of his new series, The Boys, a bad guy who's sort of the good guy, even though he's really a bad guy, but he's helping take down bad guys who are supposed to be good guys, but are actually bad guys. He seems like a good guy.